हेलो एवरीवन, वार्म वेलकम टू ईच वन ऑफ यू हियर फॉर द वर्चुअल सेशन ऑफ साइंस एंड आई एम वेरी मच होपफुल यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेरी वेल चिल्ड्रेन एंड अ जेंटल रिमाइंडर अबाउट योर नोटबुक आई होप इट इज़ कंप्लीटेड ऑल द पॉइंट्स एंड द डायग्राम्स मेंशन इन द प्रीवियस सेशन आई होप यू हैव टेकन डाउन ऑल सो लेट अस सी व्हाट आर वी गोइंग टू हैव इन दिस वर्चुअल सेशन व्हाट आर वी गोइंग टू डू इन दिस चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिक करंट एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स. So we are going to continue with the concept which you have learned in the previous session. Let us see what are we having in this session. So we are going to learn, first of all, this was the circuit diagram of electric circuit which was told to you to be drawn in the notebook. I hope you have drawn this in your notebook. Just a gentle reminder to everyone. So that we can continue with the chapter, we can continue with the concepts. I hope this is there in your notebook. So let us learn about the electric circuit. We are going to learn about the bulb, how it works. So let us see some components which you have learned about the electrical components. Let us see them in detail and we will see how the effect of electric current work. There are two effects which we are going to learn in this chapter. So let us see, first of all, the electric circuit shown here consists of a bulb. You are going to continue to write the notes. I hope you have drawn the diagram. So you are going to draw the diagram and continue to write these notes. The electric circuit shown here consists of a bulb. As you see, the bulb has a wire present inside it called the filament. When the electric current passes through the filament, it closed. The filaments break when the bulb gets fused. So this is a filament which made of tungsten, which has a very fine filament of metal called tungsten, which is used over here, and it's got a very high melting point. But when the filament break, when you use it continuously after a longer period of time, the filament will break. That means the bulb will be discarded. That means the bulb is of no use. That means the bulb get fused. So a bulb consists of a very fine thin filament of a metal called tungsten. Please do write all this in your notebook, children. What happens when the filament of a bulb breaks? So you have to see this diagram in your notebook. You can draw and please label the diagram. First have a look at this, then you draw. So bulb, you can see a glass bulb have a fine filament made up of tungsten, that is a metal having a very high melting point, because due to electric current it will cause metal to get heated up and it will melt. So it has to have a high melting point. But a time comes where this fine filament, when you continuously use bulb, due to continuous use of the bulb, the filament will break, and that means the bulb has to be discarded. The bulb is of no use and it has a support and a fitting. So please draw this diagram in your notebook, children. This is a light bulb commonly seen at home, glass bulb filament with a support and fitting. Then when the filament of a bulb breaks, the circuit of the bulb becomes incomplete and the bulb does not glow, as it does not receive any electricity. Please take this down in your notebook, children. I hope you are writing, children. Please maintain your notebook. Then you are going to learn about the heating effect of electric current. The main component of the electric circuit was the bulb which we have learned, and those bulbs which we have normally used at home in earlier times. Nowadays we use more advanced one. We are going to see all that in the upcoming sessions. First of all, here we are going to see the heating effect of electric current. What does that mean? When electric current flows, there is some effect. There are two effects which you are going to learn in this chapter, that is heating effect of electric current, and we are going to learn about magnetic effect of electric current. In the upcoming session you are going to learn that, but in today's session you are going to learn heating effect. What happens when electric current passes through a gadget or electrical circuit or to electrical devices? Let us see what are the effects. When an electric current passes through a wire, the wire gets heated up. This is known as the heating effect of electric current. So it is not just the flow of the electrons in the wire. What happened, there is some work done, and that work done means it get heated up. That means heat energy is developed due to the flow of the electrons, due to the flow of the electric current. That is actually the heating effect of electric current. The heat that is produced in the wire depends upon the following factors. So there are certain factors determining the amount of heat that is generated. It is not that every wire or every electrical gadget will produce the same amount of heat. It depends upon the various factors such as the material of the wire, the length of the wire, and the thickness of the wire. So when electricity is passed through the wire, you all know wire with the insulation you have, where it is connected to various electrical appliances at home, and nowadays it is all concealed in the wall. You can't see those connections. It is all concealed, and you can see only the electrical gadgets working when you're putting in the switch on position. But when electricity is passing through those wires, there's a copper wire inside that insulation, and that copper wire get heated up. And the amount of heat generated depends upon the material of the wire, the length of the wire, and the thickness of the wire. Please write down, all these are very important points, children. Then here you have many appliances working on the heating effect of electric current. Now this find a very good application in all the electrical devices which we are using at home in a day-to-day life. This effect of heating effect of electric current becomes very much useful where electric heater, electric iron, electric stove, geysers, electric coffee maker, toaster, hair dryer. So all these where you are using electric appliances, and those appliances generate heat due to heating effect of electric current. So that effect is very much useful, which can be utilized, which has a practical application in all these devices which you are using at home. So you must have realized at home when you are using grinder, mixer grinder, when you are continuously putting the motor on and you are continuously using it, it becomes warm, or sometimes it becomes very hot. It is all because the heating effect of the electric current. And that heat is utilized where you are using electric iron, electric stove, geysers, coffee makers, toaster, hair dryer, and electric heater. I hope this application of heating effect of electric current is very clear. This is all which you use in a day-to-day life, children. Here you can see the electric heater. All these we use at home. Electric room heater, you can see. Electric iron, which we are using to iron clothes. Electric kettle. All these for the application of the heating effect of electric current. When electric current is passed through the electrical wire or through the electrical appliances, it generates heat. Because some amount of work is done with the flow of electrons. Actually, electric current is the flow of electrons. Some amount of energy, that is heat energy, is given out. All these elements produce high amount of heat when electricity passes through them. However, this amount can change depending upon the requirement of the device. So it all depends upon the making of the device, the material used. It will not produce the same amount of heat. Like when you are ironing clothes, you can regulate the temperature of the iron for the various fabric material which you are using. For cotton, for silk, for nylon, for rayon, you have various range of the temperature. So that can be manipulated. So the device is made like that. Whereas in geyser, the amount of heat produced will be different from the iron. It will not produce the same amount of heat, otherwise it will have a blast. So different amount of heat is depend upon the making of how it is being prepared. This is so because they contain a coil of wire known as an element. So the wire is made up of an element, copper wire or any alloy can be used as a wire to generate heat. So they are coiling it inside a particular device that produces heat, and that coiling is different in every device, and depending upon the amount of heat required by such appliances, different types, sizes and length of the wire are used in them. Some wires can break down or melt as they get heated. So then time comes where your iron doesn't work or geyser doesn't work because of overheating, the coil, the wire will melt, and that will make the device useless, or you have to repair it because of the coil gets spoiled because of melting. Too much of heating also will melt the wire. So this is actually the application of heating effect of electric current, children. Please write it down in your notebook. I hope the concepts are clear with you all. So here we come to an end of the session, children. Understanding of the concept for this chapter is extremely important, children. I'm just repeating myself. Please understand concepts and then you can write and then you can learn. And please write down points discussed. Please draw the diagrams which are mentioned to be drawn in the notebook. I hope everything is very clear with you all. Thank you, children, and have a wonderful day.